today's a day we almost didn't think would arrive, but it's here. Right behind me, I've got a transport truck getting ready to pick up a very special unit. Real quick, so here's ship row. There's a very special unit right here. While I have the opportunity, I wanted to share a couple of things. A lot of people are probably thinking right now, JD's totally sold out. JD is getting a free unit. He's gonna praise this thing stem to stern. All we ask is that JD be 100% honest. He is paying for this unit 100% with his own money. This is not a sponsored unit by Coachman or anything like that. JD's buying this for his family to use and for the channel. We are excited to be able to get the direct feedback from his viewers on his channel. That's all we're looking for. JD was able to have a unique opportunity to be able to help with the concept and some of the design. And he's been very instrumental in some of the componentry that we've picked. Give us the feedback, let us know what you like, what you don't like. I'm gonna jump on a plane, head down to Seguin, Texas. JD, thanks again. You have the patience of Moses. We'll talk to you soon.
What's going on, guys? So today is one very special day because in front of me is our new Coachman Brookstone 398 MBL. This honestly took over a year and a half to get to where we're at today. So I hope you're excited about it because this is a pretty cool time for me, for the channel, and those who have been following this build. So in front of me, you got Ken. Ken is the owner of Seguin RV in Seguin, Texas. They are a Coachman Brookstone and Chaparral dealership. Plus, you guys carry a ton of other brands as well in just about every size, weight, and length, the travel trailer or fifth wheel someone's looking for, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, so right off the bat, first of all, thank you for your hospitality and, you know, working with us to get this Brookstone down here and get it prepped. Your team was absolutely fantastic. They installed the goose box. Right there, you guys know I have the beloved goose box on this unit, 20,000 pound rated goose box. But I wanted to take a moment and introduce you guys to Ken because Ken and his team, again, have been very hospitable in terms of getting this set up, cleaned, and ready to show you all on the channel. So, Ken, take it away.
Well, I'd like to take a moment and first say thank you very much for this opportunity. As you will know, we started this relationship quite some time ago, and it's really been a good one. This is a fantastic product. We are very proud to be Coachman representatives. Coachman has been around for 50 plus years. They're innovative in their designs. And as you can tell, they listen to their customers. JD was instrumental in getting this camper built the way that it was. There's some great, wonderful little things that have been done. And it's because of your insight that we're able to bring this product to you today.
I appreciate it. And when he said we had a relationship that goes back, this is the dealership that I bought the Coachman Chaparral that we had four and a half years ago on the channel, right? And we just recently sold it to some good friends of ours who also love that unit. So the reality behind buying an RV isn't sometimes that you're gonna have the perfect unit with no problems, nothing's gonna happen. It's the relationship. It's the folks that take care of you, the folks that sell it to you, the folks that make it for you, and what they're willing to do. And the reason why I chose to come back and do business with Seguin RV in Seguin, Texas is because of that relationship. That was important to me.
Well, so. It's very true what you're saying. These are one of the few products you can still buy today. They're built by human hands. Really, real people build these, and things don't always go perfectly. And when they don't, we work really hard to find a way to get the solution to get you back on the road, because you bought the camper to go camping, not to go fix it.
Yep. I'm 2 hours away from Seguin in Corpus Christi, and we did have an issue with our Chaparral. I called up Ken, the owner, actually got back in touch with me, and he said, you know what, you can bring it back. We'd be happy to take care of it. We can get a technician down there, or, you know, if you want, we'll send you the parts. And I told him, send me the parts. I'll do it myself.
So. Sometimes the repairs are very, very simple and very, very easy. And even if you're having a problem and you can't quite get the repair done right then and there, we know a lot of little workarounds to get you going so that you can keep your camping experience going for the weekend so you can enjoy yourself.
Absolutely. As frustrated as some issues may be at times, you don't want it to disrupt your entire trip if it's something that's relatively easy or simple to fix. Like I always tell my viewers, to own an RV, you pretty much have to know how to use a hammer and a power drill.
A power drill and a hammer are very helpful.
Yep. So, Ken, again, I really appreciate it. It's actually a very, very good feeling to know that I'm buying it again, repeat business to this gentleman, because they took such good care of me the first time. So, Ken, I really appreciate it.
Well, and I thank you, JD, for getting with the factory, making these improvements, and getting an even better product for us so that we can have a product to sell to our clientele that they're really going to enjoy.
Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
All right.
Okay, so now in front of me, we have the legendary David Hofer with Coachmen Fifth Wheels. So this is the gentleman that has likely been fed up with the number of emails and texts that I send him like every single day for the last year and a half. I mean, it's been crazy. He's got such crazy patience that I have to commend you for that. But in all seriousness, this guy is super awesome. He has worked very closely with me to help make sure that the message I've delivered to Coachmen as part of this collaboration is heard and has been applied to this specific unit. There's things that we've done that no Brookstone may ever get, but then there are things that we've done that they really want to know, do you want to see in a Brookstone? But also find out if you want to see them add and you're willing to pay for in a Brookstone. So there's so many aspects to this collaboration that are well beyond just producing a unit that you see in front of you. And I wanted to give David an opportunity to kind of speak from a coachman's perspective on how you felt this collaboration went and what you're looking for out of it.
Sure. And I'm, first of all, I have to thank your viewers. You have the patience of Moses, JD. I have to honestly say that. This is obviously number two. This is not the first unit. So we built two units for JD. The first unit, to be totally honest, we had COVID hit. We had a model year changeover. We did not want you to have a unit that didn't have all of the updates. So we scrapped the first unit. We started construction on the second one. That was an interesting phone call that day.
Oh, yeah.
Anyhow, so the whole idea behind this, it's a concept unit. It's based on a floor plan that is available today, but I have to be forthright in the fact that this unit, JD's unit, as it sits today, is not available. What Coachmen hopes to get out of this, the only thing that we're looking for is your direct customer feedback, or our customer feedback, your viewers. We want to know what you like and what you don't like. There's probably 25 items on this unit, as JD said, that are not standard items. We worked with outside vendors, suppliers. There's some neat things on here that you will see that are not even available in, you know, the standard market right now. So we can't thank you enough for the opportunity. You know, to have this type of source for direct feedback for our, you know, our customer base and your viewers, it's exactly what we're looking for. So the other thing we need to let customers know, JD, you have not sold out. You guys have to trust me on this one. This unit is being paid for stem to stern by JD for his family to use for the channel. This is a concept unit. It's a prototype unit, but it was a collaboration. JD was so instrumental in some of the componentry that we used. You'll see the interior design, tires, axles, entry steps. There's just so many things that JD had input on, and we thank you so much for that opportunity. A lot of products that you see on our current Chaparral, Chaparral Lite, Brookstone was because of the direct feedback from your viewers. So that's why we're here. That's why we're doing this. It's what it's all about, and we appreciate the opportunity.
And what he's referring to is the fact that I ran polls a while back where I questioned my viewers on things that they would like to see. Yeah. Is offering disc brakes something that would be, you know, a feature you'd pay for as an upgrade option? Offering lighting in other areas, alternative things like that, G-rated tires, upgraded suspension.
LED lights.
Yep. Yeah. And almost everything from that poll has actually made it into the current Brookstone and Chaparral. You guys went full steam ahead.
We are listening.
Yep, and that is really, really great. And that's why this collaboration, I feel, has worked out so well for both parties. That being said, when it comes to the conversation that we had when we first started all this and we figured out how this collaboration was gonna work, I know from the coachman's side, they were kind of thinking, well, is he gonna get one of these units?
Right.
Or how is he supposed to get this unit? Is he trying to get us to provide him one for free? What is he looking for? And I knew that that would be a question, and I didn't want it to be an awkward thing. So right off the bat, at the very beginning, I said, I want to buy this unit.
Right.
It's not going to be something I want you to even question giving me for free. I didn't want that conversation to even circulate around. I wanted them to know right off the bat that I planned on paying for this unit.
Right.
So that's a big part of it.
And the same thing. We just really respect the genuine aspect of your channel. It's really hard to find individuals like yourself on this type of medium that you can trust, and we see that in you. But ultimately, JD, we really just want your viewers' feedback. So tell us what you like, tell us what you don't like. If you like the new tires, let us know, comment, subscribe. I'm going to make it a point to follow back up with all of the comments. So if anybody has any direct questions for Coachman, please comment. JD will get back to you. He's really good about doing that, but that's what this is all about, folks. So thank you for the opportunity, JD. I do appreciate it.
I appreciate it as well. So this is gonna be kind of the introduction video. You guys have a pretty good idea of what the unit looks like now, but we're gonna dive deeper in, do a full walkthrough of the unit, talk about all the cool things that have been done to this unit that are, again, more conceptual rather than production. Because I want you guys to know what is on this unit that's currently not on the Brookstone, and what is on this unit that are on every Brookstone, because you should know that. So, this is definitely a good time to subscribe. I didn't want to make this video 30 minutes long, so I'm trying to make as many videos that are right to the point as possible, because I want you guys to be able to go to a video and see what you want to see. Anyways, please take a moment, subscribe to my channel, because the next video is going to dive much deeper into this brand new concept, Brookstone 398 MBL.